Fraser Island hosts some fantastic fishing spots and is a perfect holiday destination for the keen angler. This is where the warm northern and cooler southern ocean currents meet, resulting in a diversity of species that can be found here. Fraser is also sheltered from strong winds, which provides ideal fishing conditions to suit most anglers. Andre and Dean's trip to Fraser Island came to an end, but as usual, there's always time for one last cast. The guys from Kingfisher Australia has really gone the extra mile to make their fishing experience at Fraser Island as comfortable as possible.
So sitting on Fraser, a few years ago we came up with a 6x4 trailer, everything was full of sand, and we decided that we're going to build something a little bit more friendly for use that contains all the fishing equipment, kitchen, water tanks, bait board, and so the idea started with a keg in the middle. We built everything around that and set up a live bait well with a bit of research in the front where you can put your tailor with an aerator. It keeps your fish alive, takes 300 litres of water. And then from there we decided we're going to put a kitchen in. We've got a pull-out drawer with a wash basin, cookers that we got in from South Africa. We also then set up some drawers where all the fishing equipment goes, with all your hooks and sinkers and the like. And then we've got some drawers for all the utensils, the coffee, the tea. We've put an inverter in, that 2 kilowatt inverter, so we can run our coffee machine in the morning. So when you get up in the morning and go fishing nice and early, you've got some nice hot coffee. And then in the back, in the drawer where the bait box goes, we have a nice big safari chiller that also comes from Kingfisher. Then a built keg that takes a whole keg with 6 bags of ice. That's got a gas bottle that we use to pour our beer in. So obviously a ladder upstairs with some rails that on top the solar panel gets moved across so that we can fit our chairs. You can sit up here nicely, enjoy your beer, watch your rods. And it works pretty nicely for us. We're pretty happy with the way it goes. Everything all in one. You don't have to worry about taking any extra equipment or anything. It's all there, ready to go, set up for these sorts of occasions. Cheers.
With that, it was time for Andre and Dean to head on home to South Africa. They had a fantastic experience in Australia at Fraser Island. And thank you once again to the team from Kingfisher Australia for hosting them. Now let's have a look at some of the highlights of this trip to Fraser Island.
No smoking and no dogs. Thanks.
So we have to stay.
Okay, so this is the tradition, how it starts, how it happens here. These guys know how to make it work. They've got a whole beer keg built in with ice.
Nice little GT. There we go. Not a bad little guy.
Got a little kingy on
a spoon
and it's a good bait size, so we're gonna keep this one for bait for Spanish mackerel. I'm gonna cook something a little bit better now. Golden trevally and there's a 1-0 mustard tuna circle with a small piece of sand mussel here. Look at that golden band on that fish.
Look here, guys, it's like a grunter's lips. A rubber lip, but it can come out like a grunter's It's not exactly the same as the other kingies we know.
Okay, so this one's gonna go back.
Bit of chalk on first just to keep it there, and then a pippy on top. They taste the pippy and then they come back. Entertaining the South African boys who've been teaching us how to fish here in Australia.
Almost like a blackfin sort of lemon shark, we're not sure.
Poseidon prototype that's been brought out with the guys from South Africa.
Fishing with a view. Not any view.
I think we've got a decent sized fish on here.
ASFN will definitely be back to visit this piece of paradise again.